There it is, the real halftime report. Nicole Pedley is at the Exchange, Ed Butowski in DC today, Mark Cook's in Cleveland, and Liz McDonald right here. Mark, you're first because you made a bearish call on the market, down 10% on the Dow by October. Make your case.
Well, thank you very much for having me. I have a proprietary indicator that I've used since 1986. It's the most bearish that I've had since that tenure of time. So the conditions are ripe right now for correction. Then we take the historical portion of it and look at that. When is it most vulnerable? It's most vulnerable between now and the end of October, 60 to 90 day window that we're currently in. Now, history's bore this out. In 1987, we had a 5-year bull market. It concluded, topped out in August. 2007, we had a 5-year bull market. It concluded in October. Currently, we are in a 5-year bull market. So we're looking at the advent of time. This window of time is August through the end of October. We should see some type of correction. It could exceed 10% or even more than that because the conditions are ripe to have that happen.
Okay, you made your case. I've got 30 seconds left for you, Mark. And you've got to tell me, what are the key components of your proprietary indicator?
The key components that I look at are volume that is earmarked toward buying. That volume has dropped off considerably since May. As I said, it is an indicator that shows where stock prices should be going. It's a forecaster. The forecast on my indicator is taking us south, which means it's bearish right now.
Mark, thank you very much indeed for joining us. I've got to move on real fast here because something else is about to happen with the president. I want to get this in first. Ed Butowski, Americans not buying much, not spending money. Would you avoid Walmart?
Well, I don't know if I would avoid Walmart entirely, but basically the policies that the president, you know, has put in place, whatever they might be, is targeting the middle class. He's trying to help them. And the lower guidance from Walmart proves that his policies are failing because they're giving us guidance lower. So you know what? I probably wouldn't be a big buyer of Walmart, but more importantly, the guidance from Walmart tells us that the policies that Obama has put in place are failing the middle class.
Okay, Liz. Germany, fourth largest economy in the world, is now contracting. Not a good sign.
Not a good sign. Europe's biggest economy, also France, flatlining. Italy, tipping into recession. All bad as the Ukraine crisis comes bearing down on Europe. Here's the bottom line. Watch the central banks over there, ECB, stepping in once again, Stuart.
Ed Butowski, the 10-year Treasury yield near historic lows. Germany yields 1%, Japan half a percent. Again, not a good sign.
No, I mean, most of the reason is when you have tension around the world, people buy the U.S. bond. They still do it for whatever reason. They feel it's safety. That pushes the yield lower. So that lower yield is really indicative of tensions around the world. People are buying our dollar and buying our bond. That's why the yield is dropping.
So wait a second, Ed. Is that lower yield all around the world, is that an indication of economic trouble to come as opposed to political turmoil?
There's economic trouble everywhere. You can't show me any place there isn't economic trouble. Yeah. It's everywhere, Stuart.
That is true. All right, Ed, you made your point. Okay. Cisco, I used to call it a doorstopper of a stock. It's not today, though, is it, Nicole?
Well, take a look, and it really ties into your global story that you're discussing right now. Global demand has been to the downside, John Chambers noting that. Take a look at Cisco Systems right now.